about is, you know, what public transportation areas are in greatest need of support from arts and cultural projects. Perfect. Thank you so much, Wendy. Mm-hmm. Feel free again to either raise your hand or place comments in the chat, and we can start to talk through different ideas.
Victor Jenkins.
Yes, thank you.
Go ahead, Victor. You'll have to unmute yourself. Victor, we can't hear you. Would you like to type your question into the or comment into the chat?
Hello.
Hi.
There you are.
Thanks. I'm sorry about that. My name is Victor Jenkins, and I've been living around the DMV area for about a good 6 years now, on and off. And throughout my time period, though, I'm an artist myself. I've always thought that the bus areas in the metro stations in general are normally really dimly lit and unwelcomely. Like, I have definitely sat there with friends that I just asked for a ride home or a ride to the bus station. And like, I sat there more so because it just didn't feel comfortable there. So like, it's not just one that I can like specifically say, I could just say all of them in general are like dimly lit and not inviting as well. And I come from like a lot of areas that have a lot of arts. My family's from New York City. I'm from the Hampton Roads area myself. So, you know, these things are really important to me as a just somebody who lives in the community.
Right.
Artists.
I think that's a fantastic point. And looking at, you know, there's parts of DC where some of the bus shelters have digital screens so that they can share art sometimes. You know, sometimes there might be an advertisement or, you know, community message. And they're very bright. So they do all of those things and actually bring, you know, brightness to the station. So definitely see that as an opportunity for the county as well. Thank you.
Yes, good point.
Thank you.
We got somebody else. Someone else hands up.
Christina Hartsfield, you have your hand up.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Good evening.
So I would agree with Victor, and shout out to you, Victor, because I'm also from the Hampton Roads area. But I would agree that like our metro stops could certainly use a lot more artistic expression, primarily because those are like the gateways into the county from other parts of the region. And when folks come from DC or Virginia or wherever they're coming from, you know, if they're traveling by the metro, when they get off at the metro stop, that's their first impression of, you know, Prince George's County. And if they're going to, you know, our downtowns, Largo, Prince George's Plaza, and New Carrollton, like, we want our downtowns to be the type of downtowns that, one second, Caleb, that, you know, they would see in other places of the region. So give me a second. So basically, I'm sorry, I'm gonna have to go. You get the point, but our metro stops are definitely in need of some artistic expression because they are the gateways. And we certainly want to highlight our gateways and have our gateways be representative of, you know, the transit-oriented, lively, artistic area of Prince George's County.
Thank you, Christina, and great to hear from you. I do want to walk through just There's been a few points posted in the chat, so I just want to make sure to recognize some of the comments that other folks have made. Pat Boyd, thank you for your comment. You're making sure that trash is picked up at the bus stops, and also opportunities for murals at our bus stops around the county. Charlene highlighted the need the bus stops to be colorful and inviting, having more plants, artwork inside and around the bus stops. See if I missed any others. Another comment from Kim Fisher, that Prince George's Plaza Metro Station and the surrounding area could use a lot more art to make it more inviting and to improve wayfinding. Denise Smith highlighted long corridors like Central Avenue, Martin Luther King Jr. Highway, a need for right sizing and streetscape improvements along those corridors. Chuzette had a comment around hosting, you know, a game show on Sundays to connect art in the community, to bring community out to a taping of a TV show. And I think that's one thing that's very critical to think about, is that art doesn't just have to be something fixed. It doesn't, you know, just have to be a mural or a painting. It can be activation. It could be something live. It can be a performance, you know, something that's more interactive, that could be, you know, done on, you know, public facilities, you know, on a metro station parking lot, or something like that. So there's different ways to actually have, you know, express that connectivity through art. Those are the comments in the chat. I'm sorry. Go ahead. If there's folks that have their hands raised there. Roxanne.
Hi. Hello, everyone. I'm Roxanne Reed, and I live in District 3. I live in New Carrollton, Maryland. And I am a writer, director, and producer. And I've done several or more shows at the Public Playhouse. And when you, I wasn't going to say anything, but when you said doing maybe things in the parking lot, I love doing skits. I love doing plays. And that would be something that would be inviting to me as a writer, you know, to be able to do skits and plays, you know, while the people are waiting for the metro. I think that would be something that I would really enjoy doing, as well as I just retired from the federal government in 2018 after 34 years. And one of the things that I noticed, they don't do, in my opinion, they don't do enough advertising of things that are going on in our, you know, communities on the metro. Is that something that might be considered? Maybe, you know, I see advertisements for movies and different things, you know, that are not of Prince George's County. And I'm concerned that maybe we could do a little more advertising. And the young man was saying, when people are coming to our city, especially in New Carrollton, because you have the Amtrak crowd there as well, and they're coming into our city, I think that we should, you know, have some sort of advertisements, posters up, letting people know what type of entertainment we have, you know, while they're visiting our beautiful Prince George's County, you know.
That is a fantastic idea. Thank you so much, Roxanne. Yes. And particularly with New Carrollton, you have Metrorail, you have, you know, Metro buses, you have intercity buses, you have Amtrak, as you mentioned, you have MART, and then you'll have the Purple Line. So there will be so many people coming through just that one area. It would be great to get them to, instead of just passing through, to actually stay a while and learn more about the county or experience more about the county, you know, as they are passing through, or come back, you know, learn something that's going on there and come back instead of just, you know, commuting through. So that's a fantastic idea. Thank you. Looking at more of the comments in the chat, Pat, again, thank you for the additional suggestions with regard to street art and performances, as well as linking in, you know, food carts as part of that. Food is absolutely part of arts and culture, and it's a great way to celebrate your heritage through food. And people will show up anywhere if you give them food or drink. So it actually helps, you know, to attract people to an area or to an event. See another comment from Alshon Bryant for Capitol Heights Metro. Sorry, trying to scroll down. The town of Capitol Heights is a sign that reads Gateway to the Capitol. beautification and arts project at that metro station would be beneficial, especially considering the span between Capitol Heights Metro and Largo undergoing the connector trail facelift, as well as the intersection of Southern and East Capitol to show people who we are at the county creatively. And yes, you're absolutely right. That is a major gateway for the county, particularly for people commuting by car, you know, into DC. So it's not only a gateway to DC, but it's very importantly a gateway to the county. So if you're coming out of, you know, DC, that's the very first place you cross into coming into Prince George's County. And it does, you know, reinforce, you know, looking at the entire Central Avenue and Blue Line corridor and how you might create that really strong gateway that says, you know, not only welcome to the Capitol, but if you're going east, welcome to Prince George's County, and use that to really celebrate, you know, where you've arrived.
Christina, I think, has her hand up. Christina Hotsfield.
That might have been from before when she spoke. Do you have another comment, Christina?
If you're ready to go to the next question.
Sure, we can move to the next question. Sorry, like, I enjoy talking about this, so spending too much time. Can you post the question, please, Wendy? So our next question, what are current barriers and challenges to connectivity in Prince George's County that could be addressed by arts and culture? So what are barriers and challenges that arts and culture could help?
I'll start off by saying one recent example I saw was a tunnel that goes between Bladensburg and the commercial area in Bladensburg and the marina, the Bladensburg Marina. And it's a very dark tunnel, pedestrian tunnel that goes underneath Kenilworth Avenue. That would be an excellent place for some beautiful lighting and murals, and just something could be done in there. So that's my two cents.
Great. And there's a lot of those types of tunnels in different parts of the county. I think about places like at the College Park Metro Rail Station. Mm-hmm. There's a metro station itself, but there's also the little tunnel that connects the MARC, you know, to the other side of the station. Very dark, kind of scary tunnel. Mm-hmm. But again, if there was art or lighting, like, there's some very fun things that could be done to activate that and make it feel safer and better connect, you know, either side of the College Park station area.
I think Dave Green has his hand up.
Yes.
Dave? Might want to unmute yourself. I'm going to stop sharing this question so we could see each other. The question is in the chat. Dave Green, PB. Pat Boyd, do you have something to say, Pat?
No, I didn't sign up. I'm in the chat.
No, we can see you.
Oh, God forbid.
Wendy, it looks like Ms. Donna Foster has her hands up also.
Oh, okay.
I'm Donna Foster. I'm with the Prince George's Film Office, which is part of the Prince George's Arts and Humanities Councils. And we do have programs that will help do some of the things that people are talking about. And that only gives an opportunity to beautify the public transportation, public places, but as a forum for artists to be commissioned to do those things. So, you know, we're open to all suggestions and locations and places that people in the county and their communities see need to be beautified through the arts.
I'm sorry, Donna, you said you were with who? What organization?
The Prince George's Arts and Humanities Council.
Thank you.
That's a good question.
Dave Green, do you have a comment?
Yeah, he put it in the chat.
Thanks for the question, Mr. Green. And I mentioned earlier in our presentation that Mr. Laurent Odd, he is Metro's Art and Transit Program Director. He is participating in this evening's session. He is your point of contact with regard to gaining permission to do an event on Metro, in a Metro station or a property. I am going to just paste it into the chat, his email address. LODDE@WMATA.com.
Could you say that again?
Of contact for this event.
I'm sorry. Could you say that again? I can't see the chat for some reason.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yes. The contact is Laurent, L-A-U-R-E-N-T, mm-hmm. Odd, O-D-D-E. And his email address is LODDE@WMATA, WMATA.com.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I'm sorry, Wendy, were there others with their hands up or questions? Or?
I do not see anybody else right now. Let's see, there's one. No, I do not see anyone else with their hand up.
There's another comment in the chat in terms of potential barriers, including walkability. Businesses that drive volume to this area, such as Old Central Avenue between Southern and East Capitol. Adding art also helps to develop the infrastructure of mental health and safety awareness balance following the pandemic. It's needed more than ever as we return to this new normal, enhancing the landscape and interchanges. Art builds an environment that encourages mindfulness and continuity of being better together by pulling resources to support the participating artists. So again, this is, you know, looking at arts and culture as, you know, connecting people, which again is very critical and very great comment, Mr. Jenkins. Thank you.
And it seems, going back to maybe what Mr. Green was saying, some of the barriers and challenges to getting art into our public places is just not knowing who to go to. Mm. So making it part of, you know, what we, putting it into the public realm, the contacts, and I don't know if there are permits that need to be obtained or what the process is for creating art in the public realm, but that should be a very seamless, easy thing to achieve. So...
Absolutely, and it's something that WMATA wants. They want more artists to help activate their stations. And again, it's not just visual arts, but it's, you know, performance art, it's music. Mm-hmm. So definitely, you know, take advantage of that opportunity.
Mm-hmm. Something like music. I just remember being in New York City and being in the subway and stopping, you know, just with my mouth wide open, you know, as I listen to the music, you know, the performers in the subway. The acoustics are great.
And particularly if you've had a stressful day and, you know, a crazy commute, it's nice just to pause for a moment and just, you know, just take a step out of that and listen to some good music and just relax.
It's just awesome performers.
There's another comment in the chat, just, you know, highlighting the need for Metro to continue to improve its lighting, you know, particularly mm-hmm. its stairways that are dark and dingy. So, yes, some stations have improved, but there's still more work to be done on lighting. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Thanks for the comment, Michelle.
Stan, do you think we're ready to go to the next question?
Yes, please. Thank you, Wendy.
Oh, okay. So the next question is going to come up right in a moment.
I do want to, while you're bringing it up, I want to highlight a comment that Mr. Jenkins made in the chat, which is an extremely strong point. The county has to provide support and reduce the challenges of permitting to be able to highlight what talent lies within the county. So yes, we do have all of these, you know, great venues and infrastructure that could be activated through art or performance. But one thing we need to think about is how do we make that process as easy as possible for artists to be able to gain access to perform.
Right. Absolutely.
The final question. What are the opportunities for arts and culture to improve connectivity in the county? So again, this isn't just public infrastructure. This is, you know, connectivity, you know, any way you want to interpret it. You know, how do we use arts and culture to improve connectivity?
That's a good question.
Roxanne Reed again. I feel like one of the ways that we can do it is by advertising. And making people aware, you know, because as someone just said, I'm in the position that I'm in as a, you know, as I said earlier, as a writer. And when I do plays, one of the reasons that I do plays is to bring people together. And I have done that, brought people from Virginia, DC, Maryland to attend my plays. And a lot of time is not advertised properly, you know, and afterwards people are saying, well, we didn't know about it, you know. If we're doing art, I think, you know, and I'm talking on a performance level, if you're doing art, I feel that advertising is the key. You know, word of mouth is good, but also advertising. So we should advertise. If we have something to offer to the community, then we need to advertise. And I can't stress that enough, you know. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for the comment. And definitely a great idea to, again, toward connecting people, you know, everywhere across the region, across this area to, you know, the artists and the performers that exist in the county. And it's not just advertising on a bus shelter, it's thinking about all types of advertising. It's you know, social media, it's all those different forms that advertising can take. But you're absolutely right. It's, you know, getting the word out about what exists and what's great.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That boy has a good comment in the chat.
Absolutely. I'll read the comment for those who can't see the chat. Pat indicated developing a sense of community. And it's not a simple answer. Food is a great way of developing community. Events that include sharing, especially for children. I absolutely, you know, endorse second, third, the idea of food at events. Yes. Because it's such a great way to discover a place and also just enjoy kind of what's coming out of a place. And it's something that, as I mentioned earlier, will bring people from anywhere, you know, for good food. And you think about, you know, how DC does that with some of it, you know, barbecue festival, the Caribbean festival, the chili festival. There, you know, there's so many different types of food festivals and people show up. And that's a great opportunity while they're there to also, you know, showcase, you know, other types of art and performance, you know, while they're there for food. So great idea, Pat. Thank you.
Universal Carnival Josette had a comment. Would you like to unmute yourself and speak to us?
Hi, good afternoon to everyone. I just wanted to comment on the last question. I really believe that the arts could be used also as a source of information. Like the young lady was saying that she writes plays and drama, she could probably write a play about information about the social distance and, you know, things that are going on with the COVID and how to stay 6 feet apart and, you know, just make a dramatization out of it and make it entertaining. So sometimes people remember things when they're made fun, a little more fun, a fun subject, not to make fun of the subject, but make it a fun way of learning something. So the arts could be used for that. Also creating jingles. I know probably you already do stuff like that, but you know, like make a song, a nice catchy song on, you know, instructions of what to do, how to safely keep your distance on the metro, keep your mask on your face, things like that. And that's it. That was my piece.
Thank you.
Great. Thanks.
Thank you.
Okay.
Somebody has their hand up. Is that
mine?
Okay. Is that Mr. Jenkins again? Is that Mr. Jenkins?
Yes.
Yes.
Mr. Jenkins, did you have your hand up? Maybe not.
No, Universal Carnival Josette.
Okay. Okay.
I think that's old, sorry.
Oh, okay.
So let's talk about
other ideas. Go ahead. Sorry, Wendy.
No, I was just going to say maybe we should talk about how we see arts and culture improving connectivity. What would that mean to us?
I just wanted to reinforce the last comment of art as relates to education. I think it's a great way to reinforce education. So that's a great, great comment from Josette. And Wendy, were you mentioning to me?
Yeah.
Do you want the group to
sure.
For me, like I don't live in the county. I live in DC, but I love to. I do a lot of work in the county, as Joy mentioned at the beginning of the meeting, and I love discovering things. And I wish there was a way to more easily discover all the things that exist in the county, because I usually just stumble upon something. So we were doing work with Ms. Hartsfield in the Tacoma Langley area, and there's so much amazing food that exists in that area. But it's not like there is a single advertised list or advertising of that. It's just, you see these great places that have lines in them, so you go follow and join the line. So I think for me, it's how do we, as the commenter mentioned earlier, how do we better get the word out about all the many great offerings that exist in the county in terms of arts and culture, in terms of performances, musicians, dramatic performances, all of those different ways. Completely agree with the comment in the chat. Walking and cycling is a great way to discover things. And yes, because you go slower, and you see things that you don't see when you're in your car going 40 miles an hour through an area. And that's another part where, as you look at how the county's investing in different types of infrastructure, particularly things like building out the trail network through the Central Avenue Connector Trail and other projects, that's exactly toward that goal. It's creating those stronger connections. Yes, there's Central Avenue, but it would be much more enjoyable to have, a safe biking route that takes you from Largo, all the way to the DC border. So extremely great comment that, moving slower and being more connected enables you to see more and experience more.
So along those lines, we are working on a project that would provide signs that direct people to historic and cultural destinations along the Rhode Island Avenue. And it's in the Atha area. So that would be along that whole bit, Mount Rainier and late Cottage City, Blainsburg, Colmar Manor, Hyattsville, going up into College Park, Berman Heights. That whole area has numerous historic destinations and cultural features that people don't know how to get to. So we have a project to provide wayfinding and better signage to direct people to those destinations. So that's mm-hmm. The thing that came to my mind. We're about halfway through this project.
Yeah.
I think, and I think for me,
the things that come to my mind, of course, in the trail system, as well as the comments about lighting at the bus stops and metro, is incorporating arts along those areas in trails, whether it be public art or performing art, visual arts along those trails, just making them creative and bright and having some live performances where it is possible But there's many things that you could do to make those tributaries, I'll say, that where you walk and you can bike and try attractive and bright and light, that people can enjoy moving through the county. There is a trail, and I found it by mistake a long time ago, that runs from Temple Hills, Bach Road, all the way from Temple Hills over to Indian Head Highway. So there's a lot of those trails that take you through the county and also into DC, I think people, we make them attractive, people would use them and find out more about the county. Because there's a lot of historic venues in the southern part of the county as well.
I think you, Jay, has, Josette, I think you have your hand up still. Is there anybody else? Christina has a comment.
Sorry.
Stan, did you read Victor's comment?
There's actually a few of them. Are artists or artist advocates of the area included in the development of projects of this magnitude? Where do you find the requirements for using public domain to sell or market your work? That one I do not know the answer. But I do think that, again, is a need, is how do we better connect, you know, artists to these types of outlets in terms of marketing work and selling their work, as Victor has highlighted. Christina Hartsfield also highlighted in a comment in the chat that they've introduced, Christina works for Prince George's County Planning. They've introduced to some of their partners in the transportation areas, agencies, is the ability to install asphalt art on the street. So actually installing art on the street that can be eye-catching and help brand neighborhoods. And you see this in different areas. I think if you've ever gone to the Chinatown area of DC, they painted a crosswalk using a lot of like Asian symbols that kind of form like dragon symbols from the crosswalk that helps remind and reinforce that you're in Chinatown. So that's a great way to use, you know, street infrastructure to reinforce a sense of place. Denise Smith had a comment with regard to improving connectivity, the perception of connectivity. You know, we have roads, sidewalks, and trails that provide connectivity, but the perception of connectivity is low because certain areas do not feel warm, welcoming, community-centered, or safe. Arts and culture could play a major role in improving the perception of safety as well as the real safety of these areas. So again, great comment around how arts can overcome that challenge.
How does WMATA feel about live concerts and those performances? Has that been something that they have embraced in the past?
I'm sorry, I didn't hear all of your question. I think it was Mr. Green.
How does WMATA feel about having concerts or plays or performances like we discussed earlier? Have they embraced it? Have there been a history of concerts at the station? We know if they would actually embrace it during off-peak
hours. Yes. So the question was, you know, how would WMATA embrace, you know, the types of concert plays or performances that people have mentioned this evening? I have not personally seen a play on WMATA property. That's not to say they would not embrace it. There's definitely been concerts of different types, from, you know, a single artist playing by themselves to, you know, small groups of musicians playing together. So that's definitely has been done. As relates to, you know, off hours, I would think that would definitely be something they might be willing to embrace, you know, largely because if you're looking, you know, off hours or weekends, we have lots of empty parking lots around WMATA stations. And it's also for them, it's a way to get people to ride the train on the weekend, and they might not normally ride the train. If they can go out and see a performance, you know, in a parking lot at Branch Avenue or any other station in the county. Mm-hmm. It's a great question. Thank you.
I don't want to overlook Yuri Borovsky. He asked, where are folks going to park at all those wayfinding destinations? And that's a great question.
Yes.
I think many of those, I think we were thinking biking and pedestrians would be using the wayfinding. Motorists also. Go ahead. That's a great question. Thank you.
Sorry to speak out of turn. This is Yuri Borovsky here. I joined this meeting fairly late for work engagements, but so I may have missed some of the introductory remarks. But I'm thinking, following this discussion for the past 35 minutes, I'm wondering if a question of private sector has been discussed, because it is as having lived in D.C. in Potomac Avenue area and Congress Heights before that. I've observed that DC does an excellent job of using the art to leverage private sector, particularly small business sector. And you know, if you look what has been done was the baseball stadium area where the old battleship used to be parked along that area, that was very transformed with, you know, artful benches and light decorations, but then basically an entire neighborhood sprung full of bars that I can't afford anymore either. So I'm wondering if we can maybe start small and kind of figure out what are some of the existing small businesses that could benefit from a surge of surge of traffic following, especially after coronavirus restrictions are removed, and give some temporary installations there to leverage that. And then moving forward, partner with the developers. I have been to a few county hearings where I'm a little bit surprised that the county doesn't have a way to tell the developers that we want the coffee shop on the first level of mixed use development, and instead just says, well, if you want to build more townhomes, let's build more townhomes. Because again, I think art is really a way towards means of creating small business opportunities in the county. And I'm not a small business person, by the way. I just really want the coffee shop in my neighborhood with an light installation next to it.
Thank you.
Great suggestions. And I will say the county has done that in some areas. So if you look, you know, my background is the Arts District corridor. There's a building on the western end of the corridor in Mount Rainier that is an apartment building that also has like a food hall space that's part of it that allows for small businesses to operate in that food hall. Yeah. So there are examples where the county has encouraged small businesses to be, you know, part of a mixed use building. But I think, you know, as you made the great point, we just need more of that. And to make that a pattern in future developments, you know, wherever they might be in the county. Thanks for the comment. Thank you. There's a couple more comments in the chat. Ms. Bryant had a comment. Has the county considered a concept likened to ArtSpace? It's a nonprofit that supports live workspaces for artists. For example, Brookland ArtSpace Lofts, creating affordable housing for artists while serving as a mixed-use building that supports creative events, et cetera. I don't know to what extent the county has created such space. I think that's a fantastic example. Yes. And it's also an example of creating an amazing sense of place where one really didn't quite exist before. In terms of, for the longest time at the Brookline Metro Station in DC, you had the universities that were a little bit away from the station, but right there at the station, there really wasn't a whole lot happening. In terms of, it was the bus loop and parking lots and some vacant buildings. But now through the Brookland Arts Walk, which is, you know, in the middle of the artist live work lofts, the artists have their storefront space along the Arts Walk and they live above it. And then there's tables and chairs in the middle. It's a really vibrant, active place. So that shows, you know, Ms. Bryant, to your point, you know, the power of creating, you know, if you create those types of spaces, one, it creates a destination. But it's also, you know, badly needed because all those spaces are filled. So that's a great idea, and it'd be great for the county to, you know, use that as inspiration, like copy that model, you know, where it's possible. Ms. Cottrell raised a question to not forget about nonprofit sectors, that, you know, in addition to other public infrastructure, there's also many empty church parking lots right now. And definitely those could be used, you know, for activation in different types of ways throughout the county. And again, bringing it closer to different parts of the community. So it's a great suggestion there as well. Thank you.
Stan,
Ms. Bryant also posted the link for ArtSpace. Thank you. Go ahead.
Stan, I think we're coming to the end of our session. I think I got the
5 minutes
notice. Yep.
Okay. I do want to thank everyone who's joined this session and who's participated. I would also say, please, you know, there was a survey link that was mentioned earlier in the presentation. Please make sure to fill out that survey to make sure like your ideas are captured there. This session is being recorded, as I mentioned, and that's with the goal of us being able to extract all the notes from these conversations and make sure that we're able to kind of act upon that and incorporate it into this cultural plan study. So again, thank you all for the fantastic feedback and fantastic ideas. And I think, you know, with this kind of input will really put us up on a strong path for the county. So thank you again.